Hi guys, this is Gautam. So thanks for viewing the video. So today I'll be showing you how to train your own custom named entity recognition model using Spark NLP. And for this model development, I have used the NCBI data. So the NCBI data is going to have annotations for the disease. And it's going to be records in it, and the records is going to have mention of a disease annotated for us, upon which we'll be building the model. And for this model, we'll be using those disease annotations as our label. So I guess let's get started. And in this video, I'm not going to discuss on the technique in detail, but I'll be walking you through the implementation part of the Spark NLP, so that you can use this as a pipeline to build your own model with your own data set. You can use any data set that you want, regardless of it. This is how we'll be building the pipeline, and you can use this code as a template to build your own pipeline. So let's get started. So I am importing the PySparks packages here. So since it runs in a distributed fashion, the training and the prediction is also going to be much faster, and you can also do batch processing. I have used Jupyter Notebook, but you can very well install this in your Spark cluster, and you could use this pipeline to build your own model there. So these are the packages that I'll be using. So this is for creating a Spark session, that is to instantiate the Spark session, and this is to build a pipeline. So when you build machine learning projects inside your Spark cluster, what you do is you pre-process the data, you alter your data in a way which is going to be easy for your model to digest it, and you do that using the pipeline object here. So right now I have included the training data frame. Let me show you what I mean by training data frame. So this is the format of the training data frame, where you have sentence, you also have token. When I say token, this is going to be the first token of this sentence, and this is the label. The tag denotes the label, and whenever you see a disease there, it's going to have this tag as disease. And when you have a series of tokens as your label, your starting token of your disease label is going to have this tag V-disease followed by I-disease. So for example, let's say your label is of length 3, that is you will have 3 tokens in your label. The first token will start with V-disease followed by I-disease and followed by I disease. That's how we've annotated the entire data set. Now what I'm doing is I'm then going to change this data frame format into a format called CONLLL lines. So basically the format is this. Let me show you. Basically I'm pre-processing this particular data frame, and I'm transforming this data frame into a format like this, wherein your starting line, right, it's going to have dot start and then followed by a line where you will have the actual token followed by PO stack. So I have intentionally introduced the PO stack. I mean, you can skip it if you want to, but I'm just included so that people will be aware about how to use this. It's going to help you in building the model, and it's going to add more context when the model is trying to predict a particular label, followed by the tag itself, that is O or disease. If you can see here, this is of length 2. The token length is going to be 2. It is Adeimantus polyposis. So if you can see, it starts with B-disease and ends at I-disease. So this is how we have transformed this particular data frame into a format called CONLLL. C-O-N-L-L. So this is as far as the training goes, I have also already prepared the text into kernel format. It's basically a text document. It is already available for us in kernel format. So then what I'm showing you here is I'm trying to create a training set for me, training set for the model, wherein you can see these are the features that I'll be using. You have the actual text, you have the document, and you have the sentence, and you also have the token, and you have the PO stack and also the label. So this is how we transform the data, and this is the split up that we have as far as the label goes. You have 72,000 of O, which is not very interesting, or we should say not a disease, and you have 3,375 as I disease and 2,971 as B disease. So obviously I hyphen disease is going to be more because it is a part of this B disease. The starting of the interesting label is denoted by B hyphen disease again, and the following tokens of this B disease, if it's part of the disease stack, it's going to be labeled as I hyphen disease. So just to be really clear, I'm repeating that. So the first model that I'm using here is the NERDL model. So it is a bidirectional LSTM, and it also uses CNN for character level understanding of the data in order to predict it in a better way. So you can read about this in this, maybe I'll include this URL here. So this is built by John Snow Labs, which is what we are using, and they have a very good documentation of what is the technique used behind this model, and you would also see how to use them. So the first thing what I'm doing here is I'm using a GloVe embedding. And when I say GloVe embedding, it's again a pre-trained model on a different data set. Again, it's a healthcare data set, and that's the reason I'm using this pre-trained word embedding as my embedding layer for the model. And then this is where I'm building the actual tagger using the NERDL approach. When I say NERDL approach, I'm using this architecture. Alright, so I'm setting the input columns, that is what is the feature that I would need, and what is going to be the output, label column, it is about the Y variable or the outcome variable, and then I'm setting it as NER, predictions that I would make, it's going to get placed there, and I'm using the maximum epochs as 4. You also have the learning rate and learning decay rate. This is what you have as learning decay rate, and I also have a batch size of 16. So it's all boilerplate code after that, and I'm also having 0.2 as my validation speed. So this is going to be my model pipeline, and you can see that I'm creating a pipeline object here. So this stage, after that, it's going to, the data is going to enter NER tag. First, the data is going to enter the GloVe embedding layer. Sorry to term that as layer. It's going to be the first stage of the pipeline, and then the data is going to enter the second stage of NER tag. And basically, once that is done, I'm fitting that in training data, and then what I'm doing is I'm saving the model here. You can see that it's saved inside this folder. And once that is done, what I'm doing is I'm trying to transform the fitted model in test data. And you can see that this is the classification confusion matrix, and this is the classification report basically. And you can see that our model is not very bad. It's doing, it's doing really good. So if you can see for precision and recall, we don't have anything less than 80 here. When we take a weighted average of F1, we are getting 0.98. So this is the classification report for you. And then what we are doing is, we have to predict, we are going to test on a new file which is unseen by the data, sorry, the model. So what we do is, we are building a, you know, a prediction pipeline here. So the same way we pre-processed the data before training, we have to do it for testing as well. So I am again preparing a document out of the text, and I'm also splitting that into sentence, and then from sentence to token, and then I'm applying glove embedding here, and then I'm loading the model here, which is what I've saved here, and then what I do is I apply it on a unseen data, and this is how I do it. So let me show you. So this is the text, and this is where I'm applying the unseen data to my DL object, and you can see what is the result here. So this is a very generic text I have used. You can see it's terming the disease part right. Coronavirus disease is an infectious disease caused autonomous, sorry if I'm spelling that right, by a newly discovered coronavirus, respiratory illness, cardiovascular disease, diabetes, chronic respiratory disease, and cancer. So I guess that the model is, it's not that illiterate when it comes to capturing the disease. I feel that it is trained well. So next comes the BERT model. So BERT stands for bidirectional encoder representation from transformer. It's a transformer model. Again, it's developed by Google. So what I'm doing here is, I'm trying to create BERT embeddings for my corpus. I'm doing that here. And I'm saving those here, saving the BERT word embeddings here. And once that is done, again I'm building a pipeline. Remember I said when you are working on a machine learning project inside Spark, what you do is you always create a pipeline. A pipeline is the stages through which your data is passed, and in each stage the data is passed, it will be processed to an extent before sending that to a model. So that is what pipeline means. It's just like a conveyor belt. So each stage of the conveyor belt, product will be processed, right? It's very similar to that. And you can see that this is the training time it took and what is the CPU utilization for the same. Again, just like how I did for NERDL, I'm doing the same for the BERT model as well. I'm building a pipeline. And these are the annotations returned by the BERT model. And again, you can see that it's capturing almost the same. But you don't see, it capturing cancer, but NERDL captured cancer as well. So there is a slight difference between NERDL. NERDL is slightly doing better than BERT, though BERT is little advanced in terms of model. When I say advanced, it was more recently launched than NERDL. So this is NERDL. Let's look at a different model now. It's called conditional random fields. Again, it's a probabilistic based model based on the interesting tokens around, it'll basically look at an interesting token and what is the word that's coming before and after. It's basically, it'll try to maximize the likelihood of an interesting case based on interesting tag, I would say, based on the words that's coming before and after the interesting token. So, that's CRF in a nutshell. It's a linear model again. And again, I'm creating the pipeline that's required. I'm using the cloud pre-trained vector. So, you don't require this. I'm reading the kernel data again, test data. We have done that already. And you can see the classification report here. So I would say the DL model is doing better, but in terms of recall, when it comes to a NOT disease, it's nearly perfect, I would say, because the F1 is 0.99. but we can still improve on the disease part when it comes to conditional random things. And I'm saving the model here. Again, I'm creating a pipeline. It's very similar to, again, if you go through the DL model and CRF, I'm pretty sure that you will be able to understand the difference between the both. So I'm giving a very small task for it. I mean, I'm trying to figure out if there's any disease mentioned in the above string. So patient was suffering from heart disease, and if you can see, right, it rightly identifies heart disease. That's the beginning of disease, and this one followed by it. This tag, right, whenever you have a beginning, and it's going to be followed by another interesting tag. So combinedly, you can say heart disease. Mention of a heart disease is rightly captured by CRF. So now I basically, to give you a recap, I showed you how to load the data and how I pre-processed it, how I transformed that to Connell format, and how I was able to create a pipeline for sending the training data. I was able to fit the data and then transform it on test data. And you also saw the evaluation metrics there. And once you have the evaluation metrics, I also showed you how you can predict these models on unseen data by the model and make sense out of it. And I hope this was useful. Let me know your comments on this. Thanks a lot. So I would also be giving you the links for the notebook so that you can have a look at it when you're free. And also the links for the NCBI data where you can download it. So I will be giving additional information so that it's not going to stop with this video. You can take a look at it, and if you have any doubts, you can post your comments, and I'll be happy to help you. Thanks a lot.